Namaste. I'm Dr. Shwetha Anand. I'm a fertility consultant, high-risk pregnancy specialist, and a laparoscopic surgeon as well. I practice at Basaveshwar, Nagar, at a center called Janisthaa Fertility Center and Hospital. Embryo transfer is a procedure that is done without anesthesia. So if you have undergone IUI cycles previously, you can quite relate to that because embryo transfer procedure is much similar to IUI. It is painless. There should not be any kind of pain when you're undergoing embryo transfer, because if there is any kind of pain, that means that embryo transfer couldn't be smooth or there could be difficulties during the embryo transfer. So basically what happens is you'll be taken to the procedure room where it will be cleaned. The vagina will be cleaned with normal saline, and then we identify the mouth of the uterus and we insert the catheter inside the uterine cavity. So once we are inside the uterine cavity, we ask our embryologist to give the embryos to us. So once they give the embryos in the catheter, we place the catheter. So this is, as you can see, this is the embryo transfer catheter. It is quite thin. The diameter could be less than, you know, 0.3 or 0.4 mm. So once we place the embryo transfer catheter here in their uterine cavity, the embryologist, they load and they give us the embryos. So this is the catheter which contains the embryos. So we push the catheter inside and then we push the embryos out. So this, we actually check it in the scan whether the placement is correct or not. It is always done under ultrasound guidance. So once we place the embryo in the uterus, we withdraw the catheter carefully. Catheter is the instrument which is used to place the embryos. So once we take out the catheter, we send it back to the lab. They check it, they push the catheter again, they check whether the embryos have gone or whether they retained in this tip of the catheter. Now, what are certain precautions that needs to be taken after embryo transfer? See, so many times they think that after embryo transfer, they have to take bed rest. That's the first and foremost questions they ask me. Definitely no. Bed rest is more detrimental after embryo transfer because it hampers your blood supply. So whenever there is no blood supply happening to the uterus, uterine cavity, the implantation rates will reduce. So I would recommend no bed rest. They have to be normal. They have to carry on with their day-to-day activity. There should not be any kind of strenuous activity like sweeping or swabbing the floor or hard work. So these has to be avoided. And traveling, definitely no long distance traveling, no intercourse. And then generally no eating food from outside, only because for the fear of infection. And all the medications which is required for a successful implantation would have been given by your doctor. So by taking all these precautions, the chances for successful embryo transfer will be greatly increased.